James Heappey.
Thank you, Madam Deputy Speaker, and it's a pleasure to follow the member for Wolverhampton South East, with whom I very much agree. I'm delighted that we've got time this evening for this important debate, and I thank Sedgemoor and Mendip District Councils and Somerset County Council for the enthusiasm with which they provided me with information for my contribution this evening. That rather tells you something about how big an issue this is for them, and it's an issue of real importance for my constituents, who have been angered again and again by illegal encampments. In the last 2 years, Madam Deputy Speaker, we've had illegal encampments in Berwick, in streets, routinely in the car parks of Burnham-on-Sea, as well at the Burnham-on-Sea Sports Club. We've had illegal encampments in Shepton Mallet and at Breen, as well as the more permanent, in inverted commas, Madam Deputy Speaker, traveller sites with perhaps dubious planning status at Pilton, Thiel, Cross and Wick, and until recently Rodney Stoke. There is a sense, Madam Deputy Speaker, that there is one rule for the travelling community and one rule for everyone else. Now, I want to share some quick examples of those illegal encampments with you, just to draw out some points about their cost and the frustration of local communities and councils. In June, just before the Glastonbury Festival, Madam Deputy Speaker, there was an illegal encampment nearby to the festival site in Shepton Mallet. Mendip District Council moved as quickly as they could to initiate legal proceedings, but it still took 10 days. And even then, when the travellers were being escorted out of the town, they tried to break into the local park in order to reoccupy that instead. The cost to the travellers of their time in the town was absolutely nothing. The cost to Mendip District Council was £27,745, and that does not include the policing costs for trying to escort them out of the town at the end of that illegal encampment. In Burnham-on-Sea at the Pier Street car park, they know exactly how long they can stay. They come back again and again, often different groups of travellers, and every time Sedgemoor District Council must initiate the legal process at a cost of £355, plus the cost of their own staff and solicitors' fees. In order to make it fair, when the travellers are in the car park, they suspend the car parking for everybody else, which is great for those who are shopping in the town, but that's lost revenue from the council as well. I will give way.
Just mentioned there how they suspend the car park. That actually didn't happen in my constituency, and we actually had the farce of people parking in the car park and receiving fines, legal motorists, which I then had to get overturned by the council. So again, emphasising the fact, one rule for one rule for another.
My honourable friend, the member for Sully Hull, makes a very good point, and indeed on the very first occupation in Burnham-on-Sea, that was exactly the case as well, where traffic wardens were giving tickets to those who were legally parked but had overrun whilst the travellers were allowed to be there without penalty. This is the main tourist car park, and now my honourable friend for Weston-super-Mare has left, I can say, for Somerset's premier seaside resort. And so the presence of an illegal encampment in that car park, especially when it's right next door to the coach park, which is an important part of our town's business, creates entirely the wrong first impression, may well lose us business, and certainly cost business for local businesses nearby. And that's not to mention the clean-up costs that the local council has to incur as well. In the nearby village of Berrow, Madam Deputy Speaker, there was a travel encampment last year on their village green. They chose as a village, because of the mess that the green was left in afterwards, to spend quite a large proportion of their annual precept on building a bund all the way around their village green. I just question whether money that is hard-earned by parish councils should be spent on preventing illegal activity rather than more positive improvements for the community altogether. And I should also mention up in Breen, a very popular tourism destination, where encampments have routinely happened on private land, and we find businesses who contribute enormously to our local economy are left holding the baby and responsible for bringing in the bailiffs and moving those travellers on. Additionally, Somerset County Council have told me that in the last 3 years they've spent nearly £25,000 on moving travellers on from the public highway and further £6,000 on the clean-up costs after moving those travellers. At every turn, Madam Deputy Speaker, there is an asymmetric cost. A cost to councils, a cost to Avon Somerset Police, a cost to local businesses, a cost to the community, but no cost whatsoever to the travellers who have made the illegal encampments. Now, the argument is that legal encampments are only an issue if there's inadequate provision of authorised sites. But in Somerset, there are 64 authorised pitches. In Bath and North East Somerset and North Somerset, the two adjoining local authorities, there are a further 50. So in the county of Somerset, 114 pitches are available. And I just ask, how many a taxpayer can be expected to provide? We live in a beautiful part of the world where we have a good local economy, but surely our liability for travellers cannot be unlimited or set simply by traveller demand. We must be willing to say what is a fair provision for councils to offer. We must reduce costs to local authorities or find a way to pass those costs onto the travellers who are illegally encamped. We must make sure that the process is quicker so that we end this cat and mouse process where the travellers understand exactly how long they can stay, they stay for exactly that period of time and then move on before they incur any cost whilst the council has incurred all of the cost in that process. I think the Irish option that has been discussed by a number of colleagues this evening is well worth looking at. We must make sure that the rules are fair for both the travelling and the settled communities. There can no longer be one rule for the travellers and another for everyone else. Yeah.